Good morning, Vandan. In the last class, we had discussed briefly about how to compute the output sequence for an LDA system with the help of DFT. As you already know that if X of n is the input sequence and if H of n is the impulse response for the LDA system and Y of n is the output, then Y of n is simply linear convolution of X of n with H of n. And using DFT properties, we know that when you convolve X of n with H of n, when you do circular convolution of X of n with H of n, the constant response in the frequency domain is Y of k equals to X of k into H of k. If you do circular convolution, if you want to convert that into linear convolution, you need to append zeros. You need to go for zero padding for both X of n and H of n. That means you should try to make sure that X of n and H of n both are having same length and which is equals to L plus P minus 1. If L is length of H of n, if P is length of X of n, then that is L plus P minus 1, right? You'll try to append zeros in such a manner that the length of both X of n and H of n will be L plus P minus 1. And after that, you can apply DFT for both of these sequences after zero padding. Once you got this DFT, you can multiply them. And after that, you can apply inverse DFT to get back to linear convolution of original X of n and H of n. There are some efficient algorithms which will try to reduce the computations required for DFT. We'll try to see one such algorithm today, fast Fourier transform. Our ultimate goal is we should try to reduce the number of computations required for that linear convolution, right? Y of n equals X of n convolution with H of n. We want to reduce that number of computations. For that, we are going by indirect method, finding after zero padding, finding DFT, multiplying them. After that, taking inverse DFT. But for computing DFT and inverse DFT, we'll try to get the help of fast Fourier transform algorithms, FFT algorithms. Overall, we'll try to reduce the computations by huge amount when the number of samples are so huge. You can try to reduce this complexity. If the number of computations are less, means we can expect the output with less time itself, right? You can try to process that X of n with the help of the system X of n, with the help of the LDA system H of n within short time. Let's see how the direct way of computing DFT, discrete Fourier transform. Let's consider X of n be non-zero complex sequence only in the interval 0 to capital N minus 1. And the DFT coefficients are as follows. These are the DFT coefficients where Wn equals to e power minus j 2 pi by n. We consider X of n to be complex, right? This is some complex number. This is also complex number. These two are complex numbers. It means this product corresponds to multiplication of two complex terms. You see, multiplication of two complex terms, we are having n such complex terms in this summation, n such complex multiplications, and we are adding them n minus 1 times, right? You are having total n terms. And you want to add all those n terms. That can be done with n minus 1 additions. It means you require n complex multiplications to compute single X of k if you fix k value. Suppose k equals to 1. If I want to compute X of 1, capital X of 1, then I require capital N number of complex multiplications. You can see this, right? 3 plus k equal to 1 in this expression. You require total capital N number of complex multiplications and you require capital N minus 1 number of complex additions. And see, one complex addition corresponds to two real additions, right? Suppose if I consider x plus jy plus a plus jb, if you want to add these two things, you should add the real parts, x plus a, and imaginary parts, y plus b. You require two real additions. That means one complex addition corresponds to two real additions. Similarly, one complex multiplication corresponds to four real multiplications. We can have the same example, x plus jy into a plus jb. In this case, for the real part, we are going to have like x into a minus y into b. You have two real multiplications, right? And for the imaginary part, we required x into b plus y into a. You require two more real multiplications. That means single complex multiplication corresponds to four real multiplications. In order to find all these n DFT coefficients, x of 0 to x of n minus 1, then you need to compute n square complex multiplications, because each one requires n complex multiplications, right? If you want to compute n such coefficients, you require n into n equals to n square complex multiplications, and you require n into n minus 1 complex additions, because you require each one of them requires n minus 1 complex additions. If you want to compute capital N number of coefficients, then you should compute these many complex additions, n into n minus 1. And if you totally observe this one, each complex multiplication needs not only four real multiplications, but also that requires two real additions. You can see this carefully. And each complex addition needs two real additions. So in total, we required 4 n square real multiplications, because each complex multiplication corresponds to 4 real multiplications, right? There are n square complex multiplications. We required 4 n square real multiplications and 2 n square plus 2 n into n minus 1 real additions. This 2 n square is coming from here, because each complex multiplication requires two real additions also. There are n square such complex multiplication, n square into 2. And in addition to this one, you require n into n minus 1 complex additions, right, from this expression. Number of equivalent real multiplications are into 2. This is that part. If there are more number of computations you need to do, then it will take more time for the execution, right? It will take more time for execution or for getting the output. You want to do everything in the short time. That's your target. If that is non-real time data, that is non-real time data. If you want to compute everything within short time itself. And if you try to recall from digital electronics course, multiplication is a repetitive addition, which requires much more computation time than addition operation. That's why, in general, if you want to comment on the computational complexity of a system, you'll try to bother about mostly multiplications. That means if someone asks you like, what is the computation order of this one, you simply say, we require order of n square computations. Order of n square multiplications, right? You see, some constant is n square. This can be called like order of n square. When n is so large, we can really say this is growing with n square, right? Number of computations required. And again, have a look into this one. You require storage also for computing that one. most approaches to improving the efficiency of computation of DFT exploit the symmetry and periodicity properties of Wn power kn. Let's look into those properties. Can you have this one? Wn power k into n minus n equals to Wn power minus kn, where Wn means e power minus j 2 pi by n. If you substitute that one, you can see this first term, Wn power k into capital N. That will be equals to 1, right? Because e power j 2 pi by n into kn, that n gets cancelled out. We are going to get e power minus j 2 pi k. E power minus j 2 pi k means that is equals to 1 when k is an integer. K can be an integer. This is same as this one, and which is equivalent to complex conjugate for Wn power kn. These two are equal, right? You can see this one. Because e power j theta whole star equals to e power minus j theta. You can say this is complex conjugate symmetry. Complex conjugate symmetry. And this is periodicity. You can see this one. E power minus j 2 pi by n whole power kn. This is periodic with the period of capital N with respect to both k and n. Right? If you want, you can cross check this one. Replace n with n plus capital N, then you are going to end up with the same thing. And if you replace k with k plus capital N, you will end up with the same solution, same as this one. Periodicity in N and K. We'll try to make use of these two properties to reduce the computational burden of DFT. We'll try to save so many computations with the help of these two properties. You can see, in contrast to the direct computation of DFT coefficients, FFT algorithms are based on fundamental principle of decomposing the computation of the DFT of a sequence of length n into smaller length DFTs that are combined to form n-point transform. These smaller length transforms may be evaluated by direct methods, or they may be further decomposed into even smaller transforms. For example, if I am having x of n of length 8, x of n which is having length 8, and if I want to compute the DFT for that one, in general I require n square complex multiplications, right? Capital N square complex multiplication. That means I require 8 square equal to 64 complex multiplications I require. But with the help of some FFT algorithms, I can try to make the number of complex multiplications required like n by 2 log n base 2. N by 2 log n base 2 means if I substitute n equal to 8, 8 by 2 into log 8 base 2. That means I just required 4 into 3, 12 computations, 12 complex multiplications. I just required 12 complex multiplications for this, right? Instead of 64 complex multiplications, I can manage with 12 complex multiplications only. That's the greatness of FFT, fast Fourier transform algorithm. But the output you are going to get at the end remains same for DFT or FFT. FFT is a computation method to compute DFT, that's it, with less computations. Yeah, the flow will be like this one. Suppose if you have to compute 8 point DFT, what we are going to do is, we'll try to split that into two equal parts. We'll try to divide that into two 4 point DFTs. And we'll try to divide each 4 point DFT into two parts, two 2 point DFTs. We'll try to do in this manner. It means if you have to compute capital N point DFT, where N equals to, capital N equals to, 2 power some integer, like 2 power v, for example, 2 power integer, then what we are going to do is, we will try to compute 2 n by 2 point DFTs. Instead of computing single n point DFT, we would like to compute two n by 2 point DFTs. But the completion of each n by 2 point DFT also can be done once again by splitting them into two parts. Like I would like to compute each of these n by 2 point DFTs with the help of two n by 4 point DFTs. Once again, I will try to compute each of the subsequent n by 4 point DFTs by computing 2 n by 8 point DFTs for each of them. I will try to go in this manner till I got 2 point DFT at the end, till that point. This is the manner I want to follow. It means I require total log capital N base 2 number of stages, right? For example, if I consider capital N equal to 16, capital N equals to 16. I'll have to divide that 16 into 2 8 point DFTs. I'll try to compute 16 point DFT with the help of 2 8 point DFTs. After that, 8 point DFT with the help of 2 4 point DFTs, each 8 point. After that, each 4 point with the help of 2 2 point DFTs. Now you can see how many stages we came across. First one is 16, second one is 8 followed by 4, 4 followed by 2, right? It means total we have 4 stages in this one. That is same as log 16 base 2, log 16 base 2, right? It means log capital N base 2, that many stages will come across when you go through this FFT. Decimation in time FFT algorithm. We will try to reduce the computations required for the DFT with the help of this algorithm. These algorithms will try to decompose the sequence x of n into successively smaller subsequences, are called decimation in time algorithms. We are trying to divide this particular sequence into some subsequences, right? Time domain signal x of n into some subsequences. That's why we are calling it like decimation in time due to this one. Decimation in time FFT algorithms. Consider a special case where capital N equals to 2 power V, where V is an integer. V is a positive integer. Since n is divisible by 2, we can consider computing x of k by separating x of n into 2 n by 2 point sequences consisting of the even numbered points and odd numbered points separate. What we are trying to do is, we are having some n point x of n sequence. We are trying to divide that into two parts, two subsequences, like even numbered samples, one subsequence, and odd number samples corresponds to some other subsequence. This is even number samples. G of n equals to x of 2n. H of n equals to x of 2n plus 1. This corresponds to odd number samples. It means G of n contains n by 2 samples, capital N by 2 samples, and H of n contains remaining capital N by 2 samples. In total, we have capital N samples in x of n, right? N by 2 for this one, G of n, and remaining n by 2 for this one. Even number samples for G of n, odd number samples for H of n. Let's see how the block diagram of that one. It's an input sequence X of n. And if you try to apply decimation by 2, G of n equals to X of 2n. If you do this operation, decimation by 2, as we have seen in previous assignments, what you are going to get is, you are going to get even numbered samples from your x of n up to this one, even numbered samples, and we required odd number sample for h of n, right? For this, what we are doing is, first we are trying to shift this x of n left side by one sample, x of n converted to x of n plus 1. With the help of left shift by one sample, right? X of n plus 1. After that, we'll try to apply decimation by 2. You see, decimation by 2. Replacing n with 2n, right? Decimation by 2 means replace this n with 2n. Then this will be x of 2n plus 1. This corresponds to odd number samples in x of n. This corresponds to even number samples in x of n. That means we just divided this capital N number of samples into two parts, n by 2 for g of n and remaining n by 2 for h of n. Even number samples, odd number samples here. Each of them are having length of n by 2. This is having length of n by 2. This also having length of n by 2, capital N by 2. Both are having same length. This is having a length of n, capital N. Now if you try to go for this up conversion by 2, up sampling by 2, this is same as ge of n equals to g of n by 2. G of n equals to g of n by 2. And this one is same as he of n equals to h of n by 2. He of n equals to h of n by 2. G of n equals to g of n by 2. These are equivalent to that one. It means between sample to sample, we are padding a zero indirectly. Between one sample to next sample in your g of n, we are appending zeros. Here also same thing. Between each sample in h of n sequence, we are going to append a single zero. This corresponds to that vector operation. Now if you try to add this one and this one, this is something like g of n plus g of n minus 1. The right shift by 1 unit, right? Once you shift this right side by 1 unit, then you are going to end up with this expression. This is same as x of n. If you want, you can cross check with an example. Try to consider some sequence x of n. For example, x of 0 equals to 1, x of 2 equals to 2, x of 3 equals to 3. And x of 4 equals to 4, and that x of n equal to 0 in the remaining interval. Just consider four samples, x of 0 to x of 3, like this, and try to apply all these operations. At the end, you are going to end up with this x of n only. This will be same as x of n at the end. See, this part is equals to h e of n minus 1. This is not x of n minus 1. This is he of n minus 1, he of n minus 1. They're typing mistake here. Indirectly, what we are saying here is, you can try to get back to actual x of n with the help of this g of n and h of n, right? It's possible. They want to express x of n in terms of g of n and h of n. That's the goal in this. Let's go for some recap. I think in the assignments, we are given something like computation of DTFT for decimation and computation of DTFT for the interpolation, right? Let's see, I look into that one once again. Let's consider ys of n equals to x of n when n even, and that is equal to 0 for n odd. We are going to make all odd samples to 0 by 4s. That's what we are doing here. This can be written in this manner, which is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 plus minus 1 whole power n into x of n. You want to cross check, right? Suppose n is even. For example, consider n equals to 2. N equals to 2 means minus 1 whole square. This is 1. 1 plus 1 means 2. 2 gets cancelled out. We are going to end up with x of 2, right? Because n equals to 2. Y of 2 is same as x of 2. Suppose n is odd. For example, n equals to 3. N equal to 3 means minus 1 whole power 3 is minus 1. This gets cancelled out and you are going to get 0. Y of 3 equals to 0. This gets satisfied, right? This can be written in this manner, because we know minus 1 is same as e power j pi. See, e power j pi whole power n. Now if you try to compute DTFT for this one, discrete time Fourier transform for this one, where s of e power j omega equals to 1 by 2 into x of e power j omega plus, we already seen this modulation property, right? E power j pi n into x of n. So let us shift the frequency by pi radians per sample. You can see this one. The DTFT was this one, e power j pi n into x of n corresponds to x of e power j into omega plus pi. And let's have a look into decimation by factor 2. This is the decimation operation. Yd of n equals to x of 2n. Yd of n equals to x of 2n. Which is same as ys of 2n. You can cross check this one. X of 2n is same as ys of 2n. Both are same. Because anyhow, that odd terms are removed from this one, right? Odd samples got removed from this and removed from this one. It doesn't matter what is the content in those odd samples. Even samples are same for both of them, right? Ys of n and x of n. It means these three are equal. Now, if I want to compute DTFT for x of 2n, I can simply compute DTFT for ys of 2n itself, because these two are identical, right? These two are identical. This is the DTFT for ys of 2n, this one, which is same as ys of e power j omega by 2, ys of e power j omega by 2. We are multiplying in time domain by 2, right? In the frequency domain, it's a reverse operation, right? Omega by 2. And replacing omega with omega by 2 in this particular expression, replace omega with omega by 2, then you are going to end up with this expression. Replacing omega with omega by 2 in both places. It means when you do decimation x of 2n, the constant DTFT will be of this form. It's a constant DTFT. 1 by 2 into x of e power j omega by 2 plus x of e power j into omega by 2 plus pi. Suppose we go for interpolation operation, it's a reverse pattern, right? We are trying to append zeros in between samples, each and every sample. You want to append single zero. Y of n equals to x of n by 2, or you can say this is expander. E means expander. X of n by 2 for n even and equal to 0 for n odd. See, in this case, you can lose some information because of x of 2n. Because with this x of 2n operation, odd samples got removed totally, right? You are losing that information. When you look into this expander, in this case, you are not losing any information in your x of n. What you are doing here is you are simply inserting zeros in between each and every sample. One sample to another sample gap, we are inserting one zero. We are not removing information in your x of n. We are simply inserting some zeros between two samples. There is no information loss here. It means, if I want to reconstruct back my x of n from this, I can get back to that one without any doubt. But in this case, I can't reconstruct back, right? Here, y of e power j omega equals to x of e power j to omega. This is just a simple calculation. Can you have a look into this? Anyway, this is covered in assignment. And why you are studying DTFT here means, we already know that DFT can be computed with the help of DTFT, right? If you want to compute endpoint DFT for a sequence x of n, we can compute DTFT first. That means once you got x of e power j omega, then you can simply replace omega with 2 pi k by capital N and try to change k from 0 to n minus 1. In order to get the DFT coefficients, capital x of 0 to capital x of n minus 1. You can simply sample that capital omega, like omega k equals to 2 pi k by capital N. That's the reason we are computing DTFT here. And let's say I look into this one. If the DTFT for x of n is x of e power j omega, and the constant DTFT for x of n plus 1 is e power j omega into x of e power j omega. Why we are computing this is, it's a reason for that. We have a block diagram, right? Here we are trying to shift this left side by 1 unit, x of n plus 1. And if you compute the DTFT for this one, we are going to get e power j omega into x of e power j omega. After that, we are applying decimation by 2. Here we are applying directly decimation by 2 operation for this, right? Now we will try to apply all these things there. X of n plus 1 leads to e power j omega into x of e power j omega. Implies DTFTs of the compressed sequences g of n equals to x of 2n and h of n equals to x of 2n plus 1 are respectively g of e power j omega equals to this one and h of e power j omega equals to this one. You can simply apply these tricks, this one and earlier slide. You can simply substitute that one. You are going to end up with this solution. See g of e power j omega. See h of e power j omega. This corresponds to DTFT for x of 2n. This corresponds to DTFT for x of 2n plus 1. X of 2n is having n by 2 points. X of 2n plus 1 are having remaining n by 2 points of x of n. And the sequence expansion by 2 shown in the right half of the block results in frequency compressed DTFTs. Frequency compression, right? Try to expand in the time domain, that will be compressed in the frequency domain. Wording by 2 operation here, right? We can have a look into this. You can see this. G of n by 2 operation. This corresponds to g of n by 2 operation. You are expanding in the time domain, you are inserting zeros in between, right? Then the frequency domain, that will be compressed. The omega will be multiplied by 2. N by 2 leads to 2 omega. And if you substitute all these things into this x of e power j omega, we have seen this expression, right? You can see this. We can compute x of n. See, note that this corresponds to he of n minus 1. You can try to compute x of n with the help of g of n and he of n, right? X of n equals g of n plus he of n minus 1, right shift by 1. And you apply DTFT for that one. We are going to get this expression. After that, rip the g of e power j omega with this and h of e power j omega with this one. Then we are going to end up with this expression. This is the final expression for DTFT of x of e power j omega. This corresponds to n by 2 point sequence. This also corresponds to n by 2 point sequence. This corresponds to n point sequence, right? X of n. Still, you have even numbered samples, odd numbered samples in this. That means we are trying to compute DTFT for even number samples separately and odd number samples separately. After that, we are trying to clubbing them, right, to get this DTFT for n point sequence x of n. This implies that the DFT, endpoint DFT for x of k, x of n, it implies x of k, right? Can be represented in terms of the DFTs of g of n and h of n. Because once you are able to represent DTFT of x of n as a function of DTFTs for g of n and h of n, indirectly it implies that we can represent DFT for x of n as a function of DFT for g of n and DFT for h of n, where g of n and h of n corresponds to 2n by 2 point DFTs, right? 2n by 2 point sequences, and x of n corresponds to n point sequence. And specifically, x of k corresponds to evaluating x of e power j omega at frequencies omega k equals to 2 pi k by capital N, where k runs from 0 to n minus 1. X of k equals to x of e power j into replacing omega with 2 pi k by n. If you replace omega with 2 pi k by n, we are going to end up with this expression. You can have this past expression, x of e power j omega in terms of this one. We are just replacing omega with 2 pi k by n both sides. And you have extra factor 2. This. And we are going to end up with this expression. And we already know that g of e power j omega is the DTFT for g of n, where g of n is an even numbered sequence. G of n contains all even samples of x of n, right? Which is having only n by 2 samples. Similarly, h of n also having only n by 2 samples. That will have odd numbered samples of x of n. And replacing g of n with x of 2n here, we just have n by 2 samples, right? That's why n equal to 0 to capital n by 2 minus 1. And after that, if you try to find concerned DFT coefficients for this, concerned DFT coefficients, what we need to do is, we need to replace omega with 2 pi k by n, right? We need to replace omega with 2 pi k by n. Not 2 pi k by n. We have e power j omega. We are replacing this factor omega with 2 pi k by n into 2 in this case. Similarly, for this side, we replace the constant omega with 2 pi k by n into 2. Replace that one. Just substituting omega with this term. That's it. Then we are going to get this. And this can be rewritten like this. This is in the denominator. Capital N is in the denominator. This is in the numerator, 2. If I take this into the denominator, then this will become like n by 2. I'm taking this 2 into denominator, then this will become like n by 2. Now, if you carefully look into this expression, this looks like n by 2 point DFT, right? Because n runs from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. This is simply n by 2 point DFT. Because see, here also you can see, right? We are simply sampling at every omega k equals to 2 pi k divided by n by 2. That is n point DFT. We'll try to sample the concerned DTFT at every 2 pi k by capital N, right? Here we are trying to sample at every 2 pi k by capital N by 2. Instead of capital N, we are having n by 2. It means, see, you can see this one and this one corresponds to n by 2 point DFT notion only, right? Notation only. This is straight away corresponds to n by 2 point DFT for g of n, right? N by 2 point DFT for g of n. We already know, right? Wn corresponds to e power minus j 2 pi by n. Wn by 2 means e power minus j 2 pi divided by n by 2. In base of n, we are having n by 2. That's the only difference here. This is same as n by 2 point DFT for the sequence g of n, right? Similarly, we can try to compute the DFT for h of k, right? For h of n. This is not g, this should be h. There is a typo here. Can I replace this with h? This is h. H of e power j into 2 pi k by n into 2 equals to sigma n equals 0 to n by 2 minus 1 x of 2 n plus 1 into double n by 2 power k n. The even numbered samples, these are odd number samples. Both of them are n by 2 point DFTs. N by 2 point DFT, this is n by 2 point DFT. From these observations, you can try to write like this straight away, right? This came from this expression. X of k equals to this one plus this one, right? You can get this straight away from this. And we can express this in terms of W n power k, right? Because we know capital W n equals to e power minus j 2 pi by n. And whole power k, as much as this, right? This term is same as double n power k, this one. This corresponds to n by 2 point DFT for g of n. This corresponds to n by 2 point DFT for h of n. From there you can have x of k equals to n by 2 point DFT for g of n and n by 2 point DFT for h of n. This is n by 2 point DFT for h of n. Where h of n equals to x of 2n plus 1 and g of n equals to x of 2n. And this is that extra factor, right? Wn power k. That means with the help of 2n by 2 point DFTs, we are able to compute single n point DFT, right? This is n point DFT. This corresponds to n by 2 point DFT. This corresponds to one more n by 2 point DFT. Can you look into this one? And one thing we know is if that is n point DFT, that will be periodic with a period of capital N. If that is n by 2 point DFT, that will be periodic with a period of capital N by 2, right? That means if I want to compute n by 2 plus 1th sample value, for example, I want to compute g of capital N by 2 plus 1, then no need to use this expression, right? No need to use this expression once again. I can simply apply periodicity property. I can compute only from k equal to 0 to n by 2 minus 1. After that, I can simply go for the periodicity property of DFT. Because this will repeat for every n by 2, right? This is n by 2 point DFT. No need to recompute once again. Once you computed for that single period of capital n by 2, then no need to recompute for the others, right? You can straight away get from here itself. You can say some computations. See, the reason for saying this is here you need to change k from 0 to n minus 1. You can see this x of k. I want to compute n point DFT for x of n, right? For small x of n. It means I should get n points in the DFT domain for x of n, that is 0 to n minus 1, x of k from 0 to n minus 1, right? I need to vary this k from 0 to n minus 1. See, 0 to n by 2 minus 1, there is no problem at all. Because this is n by 2 point DFT, this is n by 2 point DFT. Both are n by 2 point DFTs, these two are. After that, there is no problem. After that, you can simply repeat, right? If I go for n by 2th value in this one, x of n by 2, that corresponds to, in this case, that corresponds to g of 0. In this case, that corresponds to h of 0, right? G of n by 2 is same as g of capital n by 2 is same as g of 0. H of capital n by 2 is same as h of 0, right? Both are same because due to periodicity. Same thing for others. This is n point DFT. X of k equals to this is n by 2 point DFT. G of k plus for the even number samples. This is for the odd number samples of x of n, right? N by 2 point DFT is both of them. Extra factor plus W n power k into this one. Again, rewrite like this, right? Because they two are periodic. This is periodic, this is also periodic with a period of n by 2. If I compute the values from 0 to n by 2 minus 1, that's more than n. After that, again, repeat the values for this and for this, right? Modulo operation. G of k modulo n by 2. H of k modulo n by 2. This will try to cover that periodicity. Let's have a look into block diagram. This is what we had done till now. We want to compute the n point DFT. In this example, capital N equals to 8. We want to compute 8 point DFT. We have a sequence x of 0 to x of 7. Total 8 values, right? We want to compute the 8 point DFT. What we are doing is, we are trying to divide that into two parts. 2 n by 2 point DFTs. 2 n by 2 point DFTs. Here n by 2 point DFT means 8 by 2, that is 4. We are trying to divide that single 8 point DFT into 2 4 point DFTs. This is 1 4 point, this is another 4 point DFT. This corresponds to even numbered samples. You can see this, right? X of 0, 2, 4, 6. This corresponds to odd numbered samples, x of 1 to x of 7. And once we computed DFT, 4 point DFT for this one, we are going to get g of 0 to g of 3, right? Because we are calling x of 2n with notation g of n. We are calling x of 2n plus 1 with a notation of h of n, right? This will be capital G of k. This will be capital H of k. K runs from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. N by 2 minus 1 means 3, 0 to 3. Here also 0 to 3. If you want to extend further, then no problem. You can extend. You can still extend. But that is periodic, right? Once you go to G of 4 is same as G of 0. G of 5 is same as G of 1. G of 6 is same as G of 2. G of 7 is same as G of 3. Similarly, H of 4 is same as H of 0. H of 5 is same as H of 1. H of 6 is same as H of 2. H of 7 is same as H of 3. No need to recompute them, right? Once you compute it, you can reuse them. That's it. Why to compute once again? That's unnecessary waste of time, right? Now, after that, we are trying to combine them in this manner, right? You can see this. K runs from 0 to n minus 1 because x of k is n point DFT, right? Here, n equals to 8. It means this is 7. And this corresponds to 4. This corresponds to 4. N by 2 means. This corresponds to 8. Let's try to go one by one. Let's try to compute first DFT coefficient of x of n. That is capital x of 0. Equal to g of 0 modulo 4, that is same as g of 0, right? Plus w 8 power 0 h of 0 modulo 4. You can have a look into this, right? If x of 0 corresponds to g of 0 plus w n power 0 into h of 0. You can see this h of 0 multiplied, this multiplication factor into w n power 0 plus g of 0, right? And if you want to have x of 1, that will be g of 0 plus at this node, you two are getting added, right? Plus h of 1 into w n power 1. If you want to compute x of 2 from here, x of 2 corresponds to साहब टू गस पांच टू जी आप टू प्लस डब्ल्यू एन पावर टू एन टू एच आप टू कैट कैन क्रॉस चेक है एक्स आप टू इक्वल्स टू जी आप टू मॉड्यूलो फोर दैट इज सेम एज जी आप टू प्लस डब्ल्यू एन पावर टू एन टू एच आप टू मॉड्यूलो फोर दैट इज सेम एज एच आप टू राइट वेयर एन इक्वल्स टू एट एंड मैच राइट लेट्स से आई लुक इनटू दिस वन अबव थ्री लेट्स कंप्यूट एक्स ऑफ सिक्स हियर इफ यू वांट टू कंप्यूट एक्स ऑफ सिक्स इक्वल्स टू जी ऑफ सिक्स मॉड्यूलो फोर प्लस डब्ल्यू एन पावर सिक्स इनटू एच ऑफ सिक्स मॉड्यूलो फोर वी नो सिक्स मॉड्यूलो फोर मींस टू राइट सिक्स मॉड्यूलो फोर इज टू लेट्स से आई लुक इनटू दैट You can see this x of 6 equals to g of 2. This is 2, right? Instead of 6, we got 2 due to that modulo operation, modulo 4. The g of 2 plus h of 2 into w n power 6. You can see this, right? W n power 6. We are reusing them, that's it. Because h of 6 is same as h of 2. And g of 6 is same as g of 2, right? Similarly, h of 7 is same as h of 3, g of 7 is same as g of 3. We are reusing them, we are computing them only once. After that, we are reusing this. We are saving some computations in this manner. And you can see some pattern in there, right? Some clear pattern in there. W n power 0, n power 1, n power 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 7 clear pattern in there right we saw earlier that the direct computation of n point DFT requires n square complex multiplications and n square complex additions but in the PS block diagram you can try to say you required only 2 into n by 2 whole square complex multiplications and complex additions. 2 into n by 2 whole square. Or combination of them, right? Let's have a look into this clearly. If you want to compute n by 2 point DFT with the help of direct method, then you require n by 2 whole square complex multiplications, right? See, let's forget about additions. Just consider multiplications itself. If that is n point DFT, direct computations required, capital N square complex multiplications. If that is n by 2 point DFT, direct computations required, n by 2 whole square complex multiplications. It means n square by 4. This also requires n square by 4. In total, you required n square by 4 plus n square by 4. That is same as n square by 2, right? N square by 2 complex multiplications. And in addition to that one, you require these multiplication patterns are right. This one you are multiplying with double n power 0, and this one you are multiplying with double n power 1, double n power 2, double n power 3, up to double n power 7, right? It means plus capital N, plus n multiplications you require, complex multiplication. It means you require n plus n square by 2, n plus 2 into n square by 4, which is same as n plus n square by 2. Complex multiplications. We require just n plus n square by 2 complex multiplications. In this particular scenario, we have just gone for one stage, right? If you want, you can split that n by 2 point DFT also into two parts. 2n by 4 d, 2n by 4 DFTs once again. And you can reduce the computations further. You can try to compare. This one will be definitely less than n square when you consider n greater than 2. If you want, you can cross check. You can consider any value n bigger than 2 and try to compare this one. This value will be less than n square. It means you reduce some computations, right, with the help of this. Decimation in time. If you want to reduce further, once again, you can try to split that 2n by 2 point DFTs into 2n by 4 point DFTs each. Like that, you can simply keep on going till 2 point DFT. And now we break the original endpoint computation into 2n by 2 point DFT computations. If n by 2 is even, and if n is even power of equals to a power of 2, that means 2 power v, we can start, right? Capital N equals to 2 power v, where v is some positive integer. In that scenario, we can divide this further. We can divide this n by 2 into 2 parts, 2 n by 4 points, right? Because we require integer, right? N by 4 still an integer. For example, consider capital N equals to 8. First, we are dividing into 2 parts, 4, 4. After that, we are dividing them into 2 parts each, 2, 2, 2, 2. Divide by 2, if you do divide by 2, you are going to get 2 comma 2, right? It means if n equals to 2 power v format, in this case, 8 equals to 2 power 3, right? V equals to 3 in this case. Here we are trying to split that into 2 parts. We can see this. G of k corresponds to n by 2 point DFT. And h of k also corresponds to n by 2 point DFT, right? Where g of n means even number samples of x of n, and h of n means odd number samples of x of n. Here what we are doing is, we are trying to split this g of n also into 2 parts. Even number samples of g of n and odd number samples of g of n. And we are trying to apply the same procedure, exactly similar to earlier one. Then we are going to end up with this expression. Earlier we got like w n power k, right? Because in that scenario, x of k corresponds to capital N point DFT, right? In this case, this corresponds to n by 2 point DFT. That's the reason we are going to end up with n by 2 here. And this corresponds to n by 4 point DFT. This corresponds to one more n by 4 point DFT. This one. In a similar manner, you can try to compute h of k with the help of 2 n by 4 point DFTs, even numbered samples, and this corresponds to odd numbered samples. Here we are trying to divide each of the n by 2 point DFTs into 2 n by 4 point DFTs. You can see this. We started with capital N equals to 8, right? It means n by 2 corresponds to 4 point DFT. And n by 4 corresponds to 2, right? It should be 2 point DFT. And we are considering even numbered samples of G of N. G of N means we have 4 samples. Even number samples of x of n when capital N equals to 8. Even number means we can have a look into this once again. Sub 0, 2, 4, 6. Now, once again, if you try to divide this into even numbered samples, see this corresponds to g of 0, g of 1, g of 2, g of 3. Even number means I should consider g of 0 and g of 2, right? Even number means g of 0 and g of 2. G of 0 means x of 0. G of 2 means x of 4. You can see the same thing. X of 0, x of 4. Odd number samples means this will be g of 1, this will be g of 3. These two are the odd number samples of your g of n, right? It means that should be x of 2 and x of 6. X of 2 and x of 6. Now we'll try to compute 2 point DFT. N equals to 8 means this should be 2 point DFT, 2 point DFT, right? We can't split further. 2 point DFT is the least one. You can simply compare with this, right? We are just trying to implement these expressions. Something similar to this you can expect. are same thing, but with n by 4, n by 4, this will be 2 points, 2 points. And wn power 0 to wn power 7, when n equals to 8. When n equals to 4 means wn by 2, when n by 2 is 4, wn by 2 power 0 to wn by 2 power 3, right? You can see this clearly. Wn by 2 power 0 to wn by 2 power 3. I'm just repeating that. Earlier you got wn power 0 to wn power 7 because you have 8 points. Now you have only 4 points, right? Wn by 2 power 0 to wn by 2 power 3. This is like computing 4-point DFT for g of n with the help of two 2-point DFTs. 2-point, 2-point. It's a 4-point, right? G of n. Similarly, you can have the bar diagram for that h also, exactly in the same manner. There, even number means this, right? 1, 5. Odd numbers means 3, 5. You can have this. You see h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, and h of 3. Even number means h of 0 and h of 2. It means x of 1, x of 5. 1, 5 are even, 3, 7 are odd. 1, 5 indexes corresponds to even, is corresponds to odd with respect to x. And you can see exactly we are repeating the same thing. This is n by 2 power 0 to n by 2 power 3, right? N by 2 power 3. Here also n by 2 power 0 to n by 2 power 3. This also. But we are converting that into form n because you can simply cross check this one. Wn by 2 power 1 is same as Wn power 2. Both are same. You can simply replace Wn equal to e power minus j 2 pi by n and try to cross check whether this is equal to this one or not and whether this is equal to this one or not and so on. You can cross check, they are identical. I'm just replacing with this other term, terminology, that's it. If you can write n by 2 power 0, n by 2 power 2, n by 2 power 4, that's also fine, there's no problem. Now let's try to go for 2-point DFT. These are the 2-point DFTs, right? 2-point DFT, 2-point DFT. All of them are 2-point DFTs. It's an expression for the 2-point DFT. If these two are the inputs, x of 0 and x of 4. See, if you have doubt, simply write DFT expression, 2-point DFT expression. For example, consider some other x of n. You have only 2 points, right? X of 0 and x of 1. Now you can simply write capital X of k equals to sigma n equals 0 to 1 because capital N equals 2, right? Sigma n equals 0 to 1 X of n w n power k n where k can vary from 0 to 1. Just substitute k equal to 0 and expand that summation. Substitute k equals to 1 and expand that summation. Then that will be exactly same as this one. You can cross check that. It's the first DFT coefficient, which is same as x of 0 into 1, if nothing is there, into 1, plus x of 4 into wn power 0. This corresponds to x of 0 into 1 plus x of 4 into w2, or which is same as wn power n by 2. And that is equal to minus 1. If you want to cross check. The other two samples we are considering, and for them we are computing 2-point DFT. Here are just two equations, right? Just expand them and compare with this. It's same. See, this won't come under multiplication because this is simply equals to minus 1, right? Simply equals to minus 1. Change of sign. You are changing the sign of x of 4. X of 4, we are converting into minus x of 4. That's it. The sign bit you are changing. is a flow graph for the basic butterfly computation in figure 9.9. We are rewriting this one. We are replacing 2-point DFTs here. 2-point DFTs we are replacing. That's it. That's what we are doing here. N by 2 means 4, right? Because n equals to 8. N by 2 means 4. And this is between m minus first stage to mth stage. Let's call them like stage by stage. Let's try to say this is first stage, this is the second stage, this is the third stage. Like this you can call first stage, second stage and third stage. We're going to compute this in three stages. We have total 8 points, right? 8 point DFT. Capital N equals to 8. We require how many stages means log 8 base 2. Log 8 base 2 means 3 stages you require. That's it. First stage, second stage, third stage. This first stage corresponds to 2-point DFT. Second stage corresponds to 4-point DFTs. Third stage corresponds to 8-point DFT, right? If you include this third stage, you are going to end up with this 8-point DFT, this all together. Between m minus first stage to nth stage, the other expressions we are going to get. If you want, you can cross check here. You can consider any stage. For example, just consider this one. This is one butterfly, right? This cross thing. This is one butterfly, including this and including this. And for example, consider this one. This to this, and this to this, this to this, and this to this. This is one butterfly. And try to compare, you are going to get the same thing. This one, exactly same. For example, just consider this one. Let's try to cross check r plus n by 2 term. Let's have this one. This butterfly. This is W n power r. R equal to 0, right? And this should be W n power r plus n by 2. N by 2 means 4. You can see this. W n power 4, right? N by 2. And let's try to have a look into this butterfly. This to this. And this to this. In this case, you can see W n power r. R equals to 2. It means we should get r plus n by 2 means 6, right? You can see this. This butterfly contains 6. Exactly matching, right? If this is W n power r, this will be W n power r plus n by 2. There, capital N equals to 8 in that example. You can cross check for all these butterflies, that will be satisfied. These are called like butterflies. Each and everything. This. And one observation you can note down here is, you can see some important observation here, right? This is not exactly in the same order. You are not getting like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. It's like bit reversal order. Bit reversal order means try to express this like 0, 0, 0. You can write replant 0 to 7 with the help of 3 bits, right? 0, 0, 0. 7 means 111. 2 means 0, 1, 0, like this. Try to reverse the order of those bits. And whatever the order you are going to get, that is same as this. For example, if you try to reverse the order for 1, this should be index 1, right? 0, 0, 1. Reverse that one, that will become like 1, 0, 0, which is same as 4. Equivalent number is 4. It's a bit reversal order of indices in the time domain. In the frequency domain, this is exactly same order, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's no problem for this. But here, you need to go for the bit reversal order while computing DFT with the help of this butterfly diagram. And one more thing you can do here is, for each and every butterflies, you can see this multiplication factor corresponds to Wn power r into Wn power n by 2, right? And we already know that Wn power n by 2 is same as minus 1. You can simply replace it. Wn equals to e power minus j 2 pi by n. And if you do whole power n by 2, we are going to end up with minus 1 for the second term. Minus 1 into Wn power r. This is minus Wn power r. This is Wn power r. See, both are coming from the same node, right? This got multiplied with Wn power r. And this got multiplied with minus Wn power r. Then what we can do is, we can try to extend this branch and you can try to keep Wn power n power r here. And you can simply replace this with minus 1, replace this with 1. Then both are equivalent, right? I'm trying to reduce the number of computations effectively. Instead of two multiplications, I want to go with only single multiplication. This minus 1 is just a sign change, right? It's not come under multiplication. Again, save some computation time, right? Because the same thing you are multiplying with Wn power r, same thing you are multiplying with Wn power r plus n by 2. And I have to take this common, that's it. Wn power r common, and I want to multiply before the node itself. And leftover thing in this is minus 1. Leftover thing in this case is into 1, right? That's 1. A simplified version of that one, butterfly. M minus 1 stage, mth stage. This got simplified into that, right? Simplify each and every thing, each and every butterfly with the help of that one. Extending node and after that multiplying with this one. This minus 1 will be there, right? You can see this. Minus 1. Try to see what are the total number of complex multiplications that you required with this method. If that is 8.dft, capital N equals 8.dft, then you required, direct method requires n square, right? That is same as 8 square complex multiplications. That requires 64 complex multiplications indirectly. Now let's see how many complex multiplications you required here in this. You can simply look into this, right? This one multiplied by some complex number, this into this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You just required 12 complex multiplications, right? You can see, nothing more than that. You just required 12 complex multiplications. Everything is just a sign change after that. And some additions, that's it. Each stage requires n by 2 complex multiplications. You can see, capital N equals to 8, you required 4 complex multiplications, which is same as n by 2. Here also 4 complex multiplications, it means n by 2. Here also n by 2 complex multiplications. Each stage requires n by 2 complex multiplications, and you have log n base 2 such stages. When n equals to 8, log n base 2 means 3 stages. 1, 2, 3. For general n, where n equals to 2 power v, where v is some integer, positive integer, in such scenarios, the number of computations required is total number of stages, log n base 2, into number of complex multiplications for each stage. That is into n by 2, right? N by 2 log n base 2 computations is required, which is much smaller compared to n square. Decimation in time FFT algorithm. The decimation in time FFT algorithm when n equals to 8. Similarly, you can extend the same thing for n equals to 16. You can extend the similar trick for n equals to 16, 32, like that. can do it as a part of assignment. There are some other algorithms like decimation in frequency FFT, DIF FFT, decimation in frequency FFT, and some other algorithms, Gorgel algorithm. If you are interested, you can simply go through the textbook, Discretized Signal Processing by Oppenheim. Thank you.